Hello everybody and welcome to our presentation of The Chain by Fleetwood Mac. Fleetwood Mac is a British-American rock band that has had a long history. The band was formed in London, England in 1967 and has gone through numerous lineup changes over the year. Peter Green, guitarist and vocalist, Mick Fleetwood, drummer, were the ones to form the band. They were soon joined by Jeremy Spencer, guitarist and vocalist, and John McVie, bassist. The lineup, often referred to as a classic lineup, played a significant role in shaping the early sound and success of Fleetwood Mac. Peter Green left due to struggling with his mental health. Later it was revealed that he had schizophrenia. Jeremy Spencer left Fleetwood Mac in 1971 under unusual circumstances. During this tour in the United States, Spencer disappeared without notice. It was later discovered that he had joined a religious group called the Children of God. Bob Bruning was not a permanent member of Fleetwood Mac, but rather a temporary bassist. Peter Green is often credited with the founding of the band. Fleetwood Mac's early music was heavily influenced by blues and gained popularity in the late 1960s. Their debut album, Peter Green's Fleetwood Mac, 1968, and the follow-up, Then Play On, 1969, are considered classic blues rock albums.
They are one of the most endearing and enduring dysfunctional family bands in rock history. Named after drummer Mick Fleetwood and bassist John McVie. This resilient group has gone on from its humble beginnings to go on to become one of the top-selling bands of all time. Over the last five decades, they have weathered tumultuous relationships. Somehow, they have waded through the drama and went on to record one of the biggest-selling albums in the history of popular music. Their 11th studio album, Rumours, released in 1977, sold 40 million copies and is the 6th biggest selling studio album in history. They are the British American band, Fleetwood Mac.
Listen to the wind blow, watch the sun.
Formed in London in 1967 by blues guitarist Peter Green, Mick Fleetwood and John McVie. The song made famous by legendary Mexican guitarist Santana, Black Magic Woman, was written by Peter Green in 1968 and appeared in the 69 Fleetwood Mac compilation album, English Rose. In the space of just 3.5 years, they went from grassroots blues to become one of the biggest rock bands in the world, outselling the Beatles and the Rolling Stones combined. But as the band's fame grew, Peter reluctantly became the focus of more attention. But it was while in Munich on a European tour that the focus of attention took a more sinister tone. Disillusioned with fame and fortune, Peter was drawn into an acid-fueled commune that left him mentally scarred. Both Peter and guitarist Danny Kirwin were drawn into an underground cult and spiked with mind-altering drugs. And from that moment, they both suffered with crippling mental illness and ended up having to leave Fleetwood Mac. Christine Perfect married John McVie and made her first appearance with the band at Bristol University. Between the years 1970 and 1974, four different guitarists joined the band and subsequently left. Jeremy Spencer, Danny Kirwin, Bob Welsh, and Bob Weston. In 1975, Mick Fleetwood started looking for a new guitarist while in Los Angeles. A sound engineer from Sound City Studios played a track he had just recorded from the album Buckingham and Nix. Mick Fleetwood liked it and was introduced to the guitarist, Lindsey Buckingham. He asked Lindsey if he would join Fleetwood Mac, and he agreed on the condition that his girlfriend Stevie Nicks would join too. The new lineup released a second self-titled album, which was a breakthrough for the band, reaching number one in the States. And it included a single written by Stevie Nicks called Rhiannon. By 1976, all members of the band were in turmoil. John McVie and Christine McVie's marriage had ended. Lindsey Buckingham and Stevie Nicks' long-term relationship had broken down, and Mick Fleetwood was in the midst of a divorce. And the pressure was on to release a follow-up album. All this led to creative and personal tensions between the band. Rumours was released in February 1977, and the album was recorded in the aftermath of relationship breakups among the band members. The soap opera of the band members' personal lives within the band was reflected in the lyrics of the songs. Emotionally charged songs like Go Your Own Way, Dreams, Don't Stop and The Chain made Rumours one of the best-selling albums of all time. A unique album where all of its creators reach their creative peak at the same time, and a commercial success selling over 10 million copies worldwide in its first month of release.
Any context to what's happening?
Characteristics of the Chain. The catchy guitar riff. The Chain opens with a catchy and instantly recognizable guitar riff played by Lindsey Buckingham. This riff is a central element of the song's sound and is often associated with the track. Harmonious vocals. The song features the harmonious vocals of Fleetwood Mac's members, especially Stevie Nicks and Lindsey Buckingham. Their voices blend together seamlessly, adding to the song's overall appeal. Dynamic drumming. Mick Fleetwood's drumming on The Chain is a powerful and driving, giving the song its rhythmic intensity. The beat of the song is essentially its energy. The emotional lyrics. The lyrics of The Chain are emotionally charged, reflecting the personal and professional turmoil within the band during the recording of the Rumours album. The lyrics written by Stevie Nicks are open to interpretation, but are often seen as addressing the pain and difficulties of breaking up with a loved one. The layered arrangement. The Chain features a layered musical arrangement with multiple instruments and vocal tracks. This complexity adds depth to the song and contributes to its lasting appeal. The iconic bass line. John McVie's bass line in The Chain is both melodic and rhythmic, helping to anchor the song's groove. Powerful live performances. Fleetwood Mac is known for the powerful live performances of The Chain. The song often takes on more intense and an extended form during live shows, showcasing the band's musicianship and chemistry. Timeless sound. The song's production and arrangement have timeless quality, making it a classic rock track that continues to resonate with new generations of listeners. The Chain is one of Fleetwood Mac's most beloved and enduring songs, and it has become a staple in the band's live performances. Its combination of captivating musical and emotionally resonant lyrics contributed to its status as a classic rock hit. We played a video.
Covering 21 Pilots and their modern punchy drum sound in the last episode, let's go back a few days. Looking at some older photographs of Mick Fleetwood's drum kits, you might not think that the drum shells are as big as they are, but keep in mind, this guy is almost 2 meters tall, and this definitely puts it into perspective. For our kit, we chose a 24-inch kick drum, 12 and 14-inch rack toms, and 16 and 18-inch floor toms. The toms are fitted with ambassador-coated heads on the batter and ambassador-clear heads on the rezzo side. Those single-ply heads have the right warm quality we need for this sound. Also, there's no hard hitting involved here, so the durability of single-ply heads is totally fine. The tuning of the batter head is as low as possible with a slightly higher tuned rezzo head. To shorten the sustain and control the tone, we use the crown gel and a piece of tape on the rezzo head and engage the internal dampeners. Captured with Biodynamic M201s, this is what they sound like. For the snare, we chose a 14x6.5 maple shell. In our case, it's a PDP concept maple drum. It actually looks quite similar to the Icon snare DW created in collaboration with Mick Fleetwood. Just imagine we have the same beautiful Rumors artwork. We installed a coated controlled sound drum head for a nice controlled sound, and to get that pretty low short 70s snare sound, we added two of Mr. Muff's mini muffs. Here's the tuning. And this is what the drum sounds like, mic'd up with a Shure SM57 on top and a Biodynamic M88 as bottom mic. Now let's continue with the biggest drum in the setup, the massive 24-inch kick drum. Just as with the toms, we went to the coated ambassador as batter head. With this head, you get the right warmth, but also a very open sound. So it was clear right from the start that we would need some muffling afterwards. We also chose to go with a rezzo head with a huge hole, so placing a blanket and some pillows inside the shell for muffling was very easy. Also, the huge hole enabled the air to exit the drum very easily, and thereby shortened the sustain. With a few strips of tape to keep the muffling where it needs to be, the kick drum is ready. With a Biodynamic M88 inside the shell, this is our Fleetwood Mac kick drum sound.
That's good enough. If you want to watch the rest, it's on the Wix site. Just a little bit on how Mick Fleetwood gets his sound and the drum kit.
Despite all of the drama, they are one of the most influential bands in musical history. Many bands have covered songs from Fleetwood Mac's most popular album, Rumours. Mumford & Sons and Florence and the Machine have covered The Chain. Florence Welch, the lead singer of Florence and the Machine, cited The Chain as her favourite song of all time. Whole Lord and loads of people have also done many covers of the band. The band was very willing to share their emotions, and that most likely contributed to their influence. Many bands were inspired by Fleetwood Mac and made songs with similar emotional delivery. The 90s band Hole was greatly influenced by Fleetwood Mac. Courtney Love listed Fleetwood Mac as an important band she looked up to when searching for people to join her band. Hole covered Gold Dust Woman in 1996. They also used a similar 70s sound to Fleetwood Mac on the 1998 album Celebrity Skin, which is right there.
Oh, make me over. I'm all I want to be.
Due to the drama and experiences they were going through, their music is very emotional, it shows in the songs. This influenced a lot of artists into adding more emotion into songs, and also their song style influenced many bands.
This is Technology of The Chain. The song The Chain by Fleetwood Mac was assembled often manually by splicing tapes with a razor blade. Christine McPhee noticed that a keyboard arrangement sounded similar to the Atari Don't Stop, as it's in the same register. She re-recorded our part with a new chord voicing in a lower register in order to improve the separation. The dobro, which Danny's going to explain later on, an electric guitar, give the production a good width. The different tones of performances panned hard left and right to create spacing. When the dobro plays, the guitar becomes quieter in the mix so that the dobro is given limelight. The harmonium and Hammond organ play in an arrangement of large sustained notes and just off central panning. The moderate panning helps add the separation of the lead vocals wider guitars and reduces any clashing between channels that are in the same frequency range. The bass was played with a plectrum, so it's given more top end bite in the mixing. The drums are also panned using audience perspective as if they were watching the drummer on stage. Both male and female vocals sing in unison and are both in mono. This leads them to feeling far back in the remix, and the chain track noticeably crescendos and builds up from start to finish. You can play the video.
This video is sponsored by The Great Courses Plus. Head on over to thegreatcoursesplus.com/polyphonic for a free 1 month trial. Fleetwood Mac were at their wit's end in 1976. Christine and John McVie were in the middle of a messy divorce and not on speaking terms outside the studio. Stevie Nicks and Lindsey Buckingham were in the midst of a tumultuous on-again, off-again relationship, and Mick Fleetwood was separating from his wife, too. On top of this, some members were nursing serious cocaine addictions, and the media was hounding the band non-stop. Somehow, amidst all this pressure, the band managed to record... Groomers is an album loaded with classics front to back. It produced four incredible singles that still get airplay today and has allegedly sold 40 million copies. Perhaps part of the reason for this album's success is its universal appeal. We've all been through breakups, and the album speaks to that. Lyrically, it's an airing of grievances about lovers from start to finish. In songs like Go Your Own Way, you can hear the tension in the band through the lyrics, but the music is incredibly inspiring and upbeat. Much of the album sounds like this. Band members taking shots at each other over top of jaunty tunes and happy harmonies. But halfway through the album, we encounter something different. The album's B-side opens with The Chain, the only track on the entire album to feature writing credits from all five band members. Instead of the upbeat rock that has dominated the album, The Chain starts out dark and mysterious, heavy with tension. The song opens on a guitar lick recycled from Lola My Love, a track originally released on Buckingham and Nick's self-titled debut album.
These are the covers of The Chain.
The Chain has been used in many different ways over the years, for example, in movies, computer games, and TV shows. Here's an example.
So big and so strong, come a little bit closer. I'm all alone, every night is summer.
It'll be just a couple of days. I'll be back before Rocket's finished fixing the ship.
Fleetwood Mac, Chain, there's something about that. And something about that whole scene where we're just starting to really butt heads a lot.
So,
I'm really certain about parting ways.
You're like an old woman.
Because I'm wise.
It's about the bonds of...
Henry, don't forget your poem. How can I forget?
So if you like, turn to the right so that we